Good evening, students. I'm very happy to meet you all again. In grade 12 business studies, we are in chapter 7 directly. Right, this is the fourth managerial function that we have been discussing about. It's a little long chapter because it deals with a lot of important things. Why is this chapter long? Because directing is a very essential part, is a very important function. Combining them in the right way, then explaining the work. okay, explaining each job and the work relationship talks about organizing, right? And the work in the description in the qualities there, we discuss that. And then who is your superior, who is your subordinate, what is the relationship between the superior and subordinate, who commands, okay, unity of command, all this comes under organizing. We discuss about the organizational structure. What are the organizational structures we have, children? We have two structures, namely the functional structure and the divisional structure. What are the two structures? Functional and divisional. So functional structure, we have each function as a separate department. Production function, production department. Financial function, financial department. So like that we had. And divisional structure means when a company goes to produce more than one line of product, only one line of product, they have various products to be produced, then they go for a divisional structure where each product is kept under a different division, a different division head. And each division will have a functional structure on its own. So functional structure can work alone, but divisional structure needs a functional structure under it. Then we discussed about delegation and decentralization of, in organizing. Okay, what is delegation? So delegation of authority, what are the basic elements of delegation? We saw authority, responsibility and accountability. Right, children? So what is authority? Authority is delegated, responsibility is ensured and accountability is imposed. Always keep it in mind. Authority is delegated, responsibility is ensured, accountability is imposed. It automatically comes. Right. Then we move on to discuss the next managerial function, which was staffing. So we know our organizational structure, we know the hierarchical order and everything. What next? We should know or we should have competent workforce to bring out our plans in the best way, to combine our resources, to put them under effective use. We need human resources. The principal asset of any organization is human resources. Right, because without human resources, you cannot implement your plan in the physical resources, financial resources, we can work. structural even, we have a separate role for supervisors. Number of organization of the hierarchy and supervisor for role. So what is his main work? To supervise his subordinates and guide them as it is required. So I'm gonna explain one more. We have to explain the work relationship. Who is your superior? Who you have to who you have to report to? And yeah, we have seen the principles of directive. One of the important principles of effective directive is unity of command. You should know to whom you are reporting. And yeah, now yaar ku answer pannum, yaar ku question pannum, clients irukku. Enakku oru doubt irundha na yaar kitta kekkanumgiradhu every subordinate should know. So as a businessman or a businesswoman or a manager, it is your responsibility to ensure that work relationship properly. Unity of command is very, very essential. So supervisor knows their subordinates in and out. So things become easy. It flows in a smooth way between the management and the employees because the supervisor is there. Supervisor irukkadhanaala, the top to bottom flow will be good and nice. Moving on, motivation. That inner feeling that we all want, right? So there should be a need. To satisfy that need, we motivate ourselves. Something pushing you, right? That pushing feel is actually your motivation. That is your drive. What is that? That is your drive. You are going towards something. Okay, you want to be a chartered accountant. You want to reach a great height. You want to start your own business. That's your need. அது வந்து என்னோட டிசையர் இல்லாமல் என்னோட ஆம்பிஷன் மட்டும் இல்லாமல் ஐ வாண்ட் இட் ஐ நீட் இட் ஸோ பேட்லி ரைட் ஸோ ஹவு யூ ஃபீல் தேர்ஸ்டி ஹங்கிரி அந்த மாதிரி சக்ஸஸ் சம்திங் அ நீட் வென் யூ ஹேவ் தட் நீட் வி வர்க் டுவர்ட்ஸ் இட் அண்ட் சம்திங் தட் மோட்டிவேட்ஸ் அஸ் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் ஆர் மோட்டிவ் ஆர் ஆர் மோட்டிவேட்டர் மோட்டிவேட்டர்ன்றது என்ன இட்ஸ் த டெக்னிக் தட் மோட்டிவேட்ஸ் யூ ஓகே த மோட்டிவ் இஸ் த நீட் towards which you are going, and motivation finally is all about the process of you reaching that particular point. Fine children, that was about motivation. We saw the Maslow's need hierarchy theory. We discussed in detail about the Maslow's need hierarchy theory, and he says that only when the basic needs are satisfied, people, human beings, we move on to the next need. என்னோட பேசிக் ஃபிசியாலஜிக்கல் நீட் சாட்டிஸ்ஃபை ஆகாம நான் எப்பவுமே என்னோட செல்ஃப் எஸ்டீம் பத்தி யோசிக்க மாட்டேன். ஐ நீட் மை சேஃப்டி செக்யூரிட்டி மை பேசிக் ஃபிசியாலஜிக்கல் நீட் டு பி சாட்டிஸ்ஃபை டு மூவ் ஆன் டு தி நெக்ஸ்ட் நீட். அண்ட் ஒன் மோர் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் திங் ஐ ஹேவ் அக்செப்டட் டு இஸ் அ நீட் சாட்டிஸ்ஃபை கேன் நோ லாங்கர் மோட்டிவேட். ஒரு நீட் எனக்கு சாட்டிஸ்ஃபை ஆயிடுச்சு அப்படின்னா இட் நோ லாங்கர் மோட்டிவேட்ஸ் மீ டு மூவ் ஆன் ஃபர்தர். ஓகே, I am working towards a promotion. For example, in an organization, you are working towards a promotion. And the promotion has reached point of view. Now, normally I don't have the motivation to do the same. Or for example, you are trying to get a 20 upon 20 in this test that you are writing right now. So 20 upon 20, so you study so hard and you got 20 out of 20. That's it. You won't take your book again to read the same. Because you're confident and satisfied with that. Anyway, next lesson I'll have one of your need. Right children, it's that. Once a need is satisfied, you won't get motivated through the same need. One need, motivate pannu mudiyadhu. One need satisfied aayiduchuna, you got to find a new need to motivate you. Right? Moving on, we are discussing about the third dimension, third element of direction, which is called leadership. What is leadership? A person who leads you, okay, who influences. Leadership is the process which influences human behavior to act in a particular way. Right? It's actually an inspiration. And who is a leader? A person who possesses the quality of leadership is a leader. Quality of leadership. What do you think are the right qualities? நான் என்ன ஒரு குட் லீடர் ஆகணும், ஐ ரியலி வாண்ட் டு பி அ லீடர். ஓகே, ஐ ரியலி லைக் டு லீட் பீப்புள், ஹெல்பிங், எவ்ரி திங் ஃபைன், பட் ஐ வாண்ட் பி அ குட் லீடர். லீடர்ஸ் ஆர் மெனி மெனி கைண்ட்ஸ். எவ்ரி லீடர் கேன் நாட் பி அ குட் லீடர். ஓகே, ஸோ ஹவு டு யூ மேக் யுவர் செல்ஃப் அ குட் லீடர் இஸ் வாட் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு டிஸ்கஸ் நெக்ஸ்ட். ஓகே, பட் பிஃபோர் கோயிங் ஆன் டு தட், வாட் இஸ் அனதர்
features like staying fit. Okay,
got sick. Okay, I'm not taking care of my health. I am very weak. So what happens? I fall sick now and then. And because of that, I can't strain much. Rather, I limit myself to a particular level. Means, how do you think I expect my subordinates to work? Or my followers to follow that? I'm a leader, leader, no? It's like, there is no time at all. 24/7 he works. So, Ramalia, when we have a leader, we say, we look up to them. Right? Amma inspire Amma. First thing is that, how hard he or she works, how they stay fit. Very important. How much they're healthy and they stay fit. Right? Because that's one important thing to work around the clock. If you are not that fit, you cannot work around the clock. Right? So, first thing is your physical feature. So, what happens to children? You got to stay fit. Right? Working, I want to study extra time, I want to prepare for my government examination or CA or whatever it is. First thing, I want you all to stay fit because I really want you all to be great people and good leaders. Right, children? Second thing is knowledge. So, we should have knowledge and skill to be a good leader. Because you should know what you want and you should know how to get work done from people. So, one other way of inspiring people is being knowledgeable. Right? If all of us are being instructed, guided, leading, then only you can be there. That means knowledge. You should keep yourself updating for that. Right? Or accountant, you can learn anything regarding accounting, regarding engineering, ledger, balance sheet, fire balance, in and out of the day. But if they are not going to get updated, and the technical and the memory use for now, technology system related among the features of the very alert, not get updated on that part, we fail as a leader. Right? And how do we do it? So, when a new technology or a new change or a new modification comes, it is essential for me to update myself about it. So, a leader should be knowledgeable because he has to instruct his followers in the right way. So, he should keep himself updated and adequate knowledge is needed regarding the work. Okay, next thing is integrity. What do we mean by this? So work for you. You're going to find me the word, meaning of the word integrity. So a leader should possess high level of integrity and honesty. He should be a role model to others regarding the ethics and values. Somewhere you are connected. A leader should be known to abide to the ethics and rules. So, professional ethics, no, so on, yeah. So, punctuality is one of the professional ethics. Honesty can be one professional ethic. Loyalty, so everybody's values differ. But a company generally expects a few things in order. Loyal are one of them, they expect one. Honest are one of expect one. Punctual are one. Punctual, na? 9 o'clock office, 9 o'clock school, and 9 o'clock work, it's not punctual. Punctuality in all the works, submission in the inner line is somewhat punctual. In order to work in the inner line, I'm not punctual. That is the punctuality. So we keep it very simple. Punctuality in time is okay in the punctuality. No. Punctuality in whatever we do, the work, within time we finish, our time management can be an ethic. Okay, so a leader, a good leader should abide, should keep up with the ethics and values so that he or she can expect his or her subordinates to follow. Naan ka follow panna. Naan time ke enoda vele unda. Subordinate mukina nanna solla mudiya. Okay, I should follow the right timing. I should know how to take it up to the next step. an integral person. The next thing is initiator. A good leader should initiate things, take initiative to do things. Initiator, na? Taking the first step to do something, taking the interest to do something can be called as initiator. Should have the courage to take up initiative. You know, we want to learn about organization. He should have the courage to take an initiative or survey panna or he or she wants to give a suggestion. Maybe the top management, say for example, the top management has desired something or a decision and it come. But you as a person know for the present market conditions it won't suit. In the market condition, it is suit up. In the market condition, the economy is falling down. We have our GDP in minus. So a growth rate is in minus. GDP growth rate is in minus and the economic student, you should know that. GDP growth rate minus in order product price and if I am increasing my price of the product means people will not demand for your product. As a person, you know that is not the right decision. I should have the guts, I should have the courage. Talk to my top management. That is the initiative. Sir, in the decision, tappa pogalam because this is the current situation. And as an individual, I will not buy the product if it is of that person. So, why do we need that? Then only my subordinates will follow that. Right? Now, in the initiative, I come. You know, the subordinate, I don't know, I expect from here. Right? A good leader should have the courage and initiative to move on, take up new steps, to try different things. Okay, if it goes wrong, I should be able to manage it up somehow. Alright, I should have the courage to do it, okay, to grab the opportunities and to move forward. Next is communication skills, very important. A good leader should be a good communicator. Identify what are your needs and lead you towards all about inner meaning. So that much is all interconnected. Okay, now, so supervision is now, you will be little close to the person. You will know right away what he or she is doing. Point number one, supervision and direction. Next thing is motivation. Motivation need to know. Why? It's an inner meaning. As a supervisor, you are closely observing. You will get there. You are not needed. You motivate according to that. And as a leader, you need what? You need motivation skills. Connect action, movement, connect action, elements of direction, connect action. Communication is also connected, because how do you motivate? Through communication. Right? We discussed about incentives in financial and non-financial. So you need non-financial incentive. Communication is a non-financial incentive. Right, children? So you, it's all interconnected as I always. Moving on, we need self. Who should be self-confident? The leader should be the self-confident. Then only he can instill that confidence into his or her subordinate. Yeah, I think now another leader, you know, in like the decision correct, good leader should have social skills, that is, he or she should be friendly and good cannot say like that. So what is the conclusion here? We should know that there can be any combination of any of these characteristics. A good leader might have these characteristics in the number survey. A making of a good leader is not a part of the program. But it doesn't mean that this is a prototype. It should be done in the real life. Okay, there might be different combinations of things. Okay, like for example, their motivation skills are too good or self-confidence is too good. Social skills instead of 75% is 50% is the it's friendly, but not like too friendly coming to the lunch after the karaya. So the degrees, the percentages may differ. Right? What is that? The degrees and the percentages might differ. Right, children? So it doesn't mean that they are not doing this. If they are only in this side, and in this side, they are a proportion different. I am doing it. Or person, I am a good leader, even in this way. Right, children? What next? So let's quickly recall what are the qualities of a good leader. Physical features, knowledge, integrity. He or she should be ready to take initiatives. Then he or she should have good communication, motivation skills. Communication means being a good listener. Then self-confidence, the person should be really good in his or her self-confidence. Then only he or she can instill self-confidence in others. Take a decision, stand by it. Even you people, take a decision, stand by it. Social skills should be friendly with his or her subordinates and followers. So moving on, the last topic about leadership is leadership style. Everyone will have different styles of leadership. Right.
Okay, let's just read.
communication flows only from superior to subordinate. Subordinate cannot say anything, and this leader is dogmatic. That is, does not change or wish to be contradicted. You know that that's not good for your decision at the governor, and you find it not suitable for you. But you cannot go and say we are leader at this point of time. So all of a sudden they announce that you have to stay for one or long. But you have separate plans. Can you go and tell your leader that I can't stay because I have personal plans? No. To an authoritarian leader, you cannot tell because they don't listen to their subordinates. Point number one. Point number two is that they don't like to be contradicted. Sir, you have to do that. Or man in the decisions area, the man in the state of the world, sir, you are a difficulty. They don't like to be contradicted. They don't like to be talked back. Right? You cannot say something again. Reply to the question. Okay? A little dominant. Fine. And why? How do you think it's useful for the organization? Where do you expect high productivity? Okay? We can demand and get high productivity. There are certain works where we need to be very careful. Little mistakes also lead to big damages in the work. You've got to be a little authoritarian at that point to ensure labor productivity. Supervisors, they follow this kind of leadership style. For what? For getting the work done in and on time and with minimum cost. Okay, for effective and efficient work. So you can see it in the factory where the supervisor gets work from his subordinates, from his workers, to demand high productivity. Right? Next is this democratic or participative leader. So it's very good. Will develop action plans and makes decisions and consultations with subordinates. So here what happens? Consults with their subordinates and discuss how is it possible, whether it is possible, all these things. So again, decision, you need one or extra statement. So I am just taking with my followers or my subordinates, work of democratic leadership. Alright? They allow the subordinates to express their opinions. Okay, unlike the authoritarian style. Here they allow them to give their suggestions or to tell their grievances. They motivate them to participate in decision making in important work that is being done. Indian decisions of the entire leader. He does not involve or discuss with anybody else, whereas here in the participative and democratic leadership style, the leader motivates his or her followers and subordinates to participate in decision making, will consider others' opinion and suggestions. Okay, so this is done. When you enforce pannuvaanga authority enforce pannuvaanga when there is a need, okay, exercises more control within the group. When there is a quick need, when something is going wrong, they get an authoritative mode and get back to that. Okay, finally, the laissez-faire or free rein leader. So, they don't believe in much of authoritative style. They don't think that being authoritative will demand or command respect. So, they do not believe in the use of power. Unless it is absolutely essential, okay, they leave them free reign. Okay, they just give them a freedom. They give freedom to their subordinates. Okay. So what is there? Freedom is there. Exercising of control happens only when it is absolutely essential. So the followers are given a high degree of independence to formulate their own objectives and ways to achieve them. Leader anyways will not communication. Your own ideas, however you want to achieve them. Complete freedom is given. The resources are given. Okay, so group members work on their own task, resolving issues by themselves. the manager is only there to support them. He does not guide them. He is just there to support them. Only when you go in need of him, he will come and help you out. Okay? So the subordinate assumes responsibility for work to be performed. இதுல நம்ம என்ன தெரிஞ்சுக்கணும், freedom கொடுத்துருக்காங்கன்னு சொல்லிருக்காங்க. I should not leave it free. Okay. 8 o'clock. So there is, for example, 8 o'clock I have to finish my shift and I have to leave my organization. So yeah. But my leader is not a person who goes through the admin or goes through the biometric every day to verify the time. ஒரு நாள் எனக்கு வேலை கம்மியாக இருக்குது, நான் 7:30 என்னோட வேலை முடிச்சுன்னா நான் கிளம்பிட்டோம். அதையும் நம்ம என்ன பண்ணிக்கூடாது, அட்வான்டேஜஸ் தான் நம்ம சப்பார்டினேட் எடுத்துக்காம என் வேலை முடிஞ்சிச்சு நான் 7:30 கிளம்புறேன்னு இருக்கே தவிர என்னோட வேலையை நான் மாற்றி வச்சுட்டு நான் பண்ணக்கூடாது. ஜஸ்ட் டேக்கிங் அட்வான்டேஜ் ஆஃப் த ஃப்ரீடம் கிவன் டு மீ இஸ் ராங். ஸோ இங்கே என்ன நம்ம எடுத்துக்கிறோம், சப்பார்டினேட்ஸ் வில் அசியூம் ரெஸ்பான்சிபிலிட்டிஸ், டேக் அப் தேர் ரெஸ்பான்சிபிலிட்டிஸ் ஆன் தேர் not compromise with the responsibility. Work life compromise will come correct ah nadakkum. Okay, so when freedom is given, we have to use it right. Even for us children, as students, as individuals, when someone, when your parents or when your teachers give you a freedom to do things, you should make sure you become more responsible. Enga the freedom irukko anga nam innu responsible ah nadakkum, right? Responsibility comes up along with authority. Here our authority comes in form of freedom, freedom of work. So anga nammoda responsibility. Right children, so you think only one leadership style is with a person? It's not that a person can be only this. We have to be a little flexible. According to me, I feel that I have to be a little flexible in my leadership style based on the situation. So a good leader should have this flexibility also. So let's add one more point. Little flexible based on the situation. நம்ம வந்து எனக்கு இந்த ஒர்க் கண்டிப்பாக நடத்தே ஆகணும், ஹை ப்ரொடக்டிவிட்டி தேவை, சீக்கிரமாக எஃபெக்டிவ் எஃபிஷியண்டாக முடிக்கணுங்கிறப்ப ஐ ஆம் டூயிங் அத்தாரிட்டேரியன் ரோல் தேர். ஓகே, தேர் ஐ டோன்ட் வாண்ட் டு கெட் க்ராஸ் த பார். ஐ வாண்ட் திஸ் ஒர்க் டு பீ டன் இன் அ பர்டிகுலர் வே. இந்த மாதிரி தான் இந்த ஒர்க் I don't want any other suggestions or contradictions from my subordinate. I am authoritative there. Work is done. Nalla mundichu. So what do? I come back to my usual democratic form where on the work ketta maadhiri, on the activity ketta maadhiri, my leadership style should be flexible. So depending upon the situation, depending upon the leader, depending upon the subordinate and depending upon the activity that it requires, okay, you have to be in your leadership style. And there are some employees who will never ever take you seriously for your feeling or the moment. Namma leader gaana enoda speed la paana illa na paana. To such people you cannot be employees. You have to be only authority. Appo oru nalla employee irukke, he is capable of doing these things, like, you know, but he is not that interested or you need to put him in mind. Abhina, you are a part of authority. Okay, you know a person who is really responsible, who is really a great achiever, is he wants to, you know, apparently a partner, Abhina, he will do his work. There are some people who will not wait to be supervised. And if you are not, 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 you are not. I do my work even with no one seeing. Abhina, you can be a free lady. Okay, with people who have good suggestions, you can be a democratic leader. So depending upon the situation, upon your subordinates, what we have to do? We have to choose the right leadership style. Okay, and that's the end of leadership. I want you to go through all the things that we have discussed about the leadership style, and the qualities of a good leader.